This is part 3 of Azure tutorial. In our previous video, we discussed Azure data centers. In this video, we'll discuss Azure geographies. An Azure geography is an area of the world that contains at least one Azure region. For example, India is a geography. Similarly, United States and United Kingdom are geographies. As of this course recording, the following are the Azure geographies available. As you know, Azure is growing at a very rapid pace. So by the time you watch this course, there might be a lot more geographies available. Most geographies correspond to countries like India, United States, United Kingdom, Canada, etc. Some geographies like Africa, Australia, and Europe correspond to continents. Some geographies like Asia Pacific, for example, correspond to a specific region. We also have a geography called Azure Government. This geography is only available to the United States, federal, state, local, and tribal governments and their partners. It's not available for general public use. As you might have already guessed, yes, Azure Government offers the broadest level of certifications, so even the most critical government compliance requirements are met. This geography is specifically for US government use, so all of its operations are controlled, obviously, by screened and cleared US citizens. Why are Azure geographies important? Well, regulated data like financial, healthcare, or credit card data, for example, may not be allowed to leave the country. Legally, your organization is required to store such data in the same country where the operations are being carried out. So, if you select a geography like India, for example, Azure ensures your data is not stored outside of India. Similarly, if you select United States, the data stays inside the states. You have complete control on which geographies you want your data and applications to be deployed. You can be assured Microsoft will not store customer data outside the geography you specify, except for certain non-regional services. Now, you can find all the available Azure geographies at this URL. This is the Azure geographies webpage. I'll have this link available in the description of this video. If we scroll a bit down, we see the world map here and all the available Azure regions and availability zones. We'll discuss what these are in our upcoming videos. But if we scroll a bit more down, at the moment, I'm recording this video from London, United Kingdom. So this webpage is smart enough to recognize that and selected United Kingdom as the geography. If we take a look at this drop-down list, we see the list of all geographies that we have just seen on the slide. Next to this drop-down list, we have this checkbox, Show Nearby Geographies. As this checkbox is checked, we also see all the geographies nearby to United Kingdom, like Switzerland, Spain, Poland, etc. As you can see, in the United Kingdom geography, we have two regions, UK South and UK West. We'll discuss what Azure regions are in our upcoming videos. UK South region is in London and UK West in Cardiff. We also have year opened availability zones. Again, we'll discuss availability zones in our upcoming videos. Next, we have the compliance offerings and then data residency. So if I select United Kingdom as the geography, my data is guaranteed to be stored within United Kingdom. And then we have products by region. So one important point to keep in mind here is not all Azure products and services are available in all regions. Again, we'll talk about Azure regions in detail in our upcoming videos. So in simple terms, an Azure geography is an area of the world that contains one or more Azure regions. Azure region is a very important concept because every time you create an Azure resource, like a virtual machine, for example, you need to specify the region where you want the resource, that is, in this case, the virtual machine to be created. An Azure region may also be paired up with another Azure region, and there are several benefits of this pairing. An Azure region may also have an availability zone. So all these Azure regions, pair region, and availability zones are very important concepts, and we'll discuss them in detail in our upcoming videos. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.